I'm going to take you through 10 new things that have just been announced by Supabase. Number one.
Supabase is now GA.
I think the biggest surprise here for most people was that Supabase is still in beta. But we had a few milestones we wanted to hit first before calling ourselves GA. We're now hosting over 1 million databases, which is just insane. We're HIPAA compliant and have been for a while, so we're safe to use for any enterprise application, any hobby project, and everything in between. Number two is another thing that's now generally available, and that's this hair. A big grown-up GA company deserves a big grown-up DevRel, or, you know, something like that. But I ran a poll, and the community has spoken, so the hat's going back on. But maybe after this video. Number three, our new Bootstrap CLI. So you can now run Bunx Supabase Bootstrap and be stepped through a sequence of questions to determine what kind of project you're building. This spins up a Supabase project, sets all the environment variables, and is the fastest possible way to get you building with Supabase. Number four, for this one, let's take a little walk. Now, I don't want to spoil anything, but there are clues all around us. Branching is now in public beta. So this allows you to spin up temporary databases for every feature that you're building in your application. When you open a PR with GitHub, a database is automatically deployed with all migrations run and linked to the preview deploy of your application. It's like Git for databases. Number five. Our new Supabase linter called Splinter. So this is made up of a security advisor and a performance advisor, which can automatically suggest security fixes and performance optimizations that can really improve the quality of your database. Each of these are broken up into errors, warnings, or suggestions, so you know the severity of each item it identifies. Number six, this is kind of similar, but kind of different. That's our index advisor. So while the security and performance advisors introspect your Postgres schema and suggest optimizations, the index advisor looks at the actual queries you're using and suggests particular columns that could be indexed to massively increase the performance of your queries. Number seven, even more AI support for edge functions. Now, rather than downloading an entire package like embeddings.js for every single invocation of your edge function, we now store those AI models on disk and automatically attach them to your functions so you can just use them. This massively reduces the cold start time as your function's not just sitting there waiting to download each of those AI models, they're just there, you just use them. Number eight. S3 compatibility for Supabase storage. So we can now use tools like the AWS CLI to run S3 commands, like sync this entire directory, but then those files are also available in Supabase storage, so you can do all the cool image transformation-y Supabase storage stuff. This opens up a whole new world of community extensions and tools that you can now use with Supabase storage. Number nine. Anonymous sign-ins. So you can now automatically authenticate your users when they land on the page, rather than jamming an authentication screen in their face and asking them to sign in. This means we can remember this user and remember state about their session, like they selected these seats. So if they refresh the page or come back later, that selection can be remembered. And then we only need to ask the user for credentials when they want to confirm that booking. This is an awesome experience for something like an e-commerce platform or something where you want to demonstrate the value of your application before hassling the user about their credentials. And number 10, Supabase has acquired Oriole. So Oriole is an extension for Postgres that allows you to swap out the storage engine. So the Oriole team has actually joined Supabase and is working on some super exciting stuff, like developing pluggable storage for Postgres. And trust me, this is a massive step forward in making Postgres more portable. If you want to go deeper on any of these announcements, I recommend you check out this playlist right here. We have a lot more theory, a lot more technical demos, and a lot more information about how you can add this to your Supabase instance. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.